Hi friends, I am Nitansh and I am at LG's booth at IFA 2018, where brand has introduced a lot of smartphones recently and I have managed to get my hands on them. So after the LG G7 1, which is brand's debut offering with Android One, what I have here is LG G7 Fit, which is even more affordable variant of the G7 1 or even G7 Plus ThinQ. It kind of comes with similar features. As you can see, it's glass back, and up front you get a notch display, and the glass back features very shiny glossy finish and it reflects light very well. But if you notice closely, it's also a fingerprint and smudge magnet, so you will need to use a case with the smartphone. Up front you get a 6.1 inch panel with Qualcomm's Snapdragon 821 chipset. That's more than 2 years old cursor from Qualcomm, but I think that the G7 Fit would be a mid-range offering, so that's not too bad. Other than that, you get a 16 megapixel camera at the back with f1.6 aperture. Up front you get a 8 megapixel snapper for selfies with f1.0 aperture. Let me just show you. And it's a custom camera app from LG, so you get a lot of modes. You can see manual, full, time-lapse, panorama and the likes. It also comes with light version of AI cam, which we saw on the LG G7 Plus ThinQ also. So the idea is that the smartphone will be able to detect the objects you are trying to capture and then apply the enhancements automatically, so that's good. Up front you get a 6.1 inch display and it's very very bright. You can notice right now it's very impressive display, and it has sharp resolution as well thanks to QHD plus resolution. Text is very sharp and visuals also seem to be very nice on the smartphone. The Snapdragon 821 chipset on the LG G7 Fit is coupled with 4GB of RAM. Let me just show you. And in terms of storage, you get 32GB of storage on the G7 Fit, but there is also another variant with 64GB memory. Running the show on the smartphone is a 3000mAh battery, which should see you through an entire day of use with ease. As far as Android iteration is concerned, you can see it's custom Android built atop Android 8.1.0 Oreo, and as of now brand hasn't announced anything about the update of Android 9.0 Pie on the smartphone, so we have to wait and see for that. Overall, the LG G7 Fit seems to be an interesting mid-ranger, but since the brand hasn't announced its pricing or availability details both for global markets as well as for India, so we will have to wait and watch before giving any verdict on the smartphone. And stay tuned for more updates from IFA. This is Nitansh signing off. Thanks for watching.